Hi. So inside this video, we're going to be talking all about the easiest way to learn ABGs. And if ABGs is something that you struggle with, if you apply the simple technique that I go over with you in this teaching, you're going to find it a lot easier to apply and to interpret. So first, let's talk about what is ABGs, right? So, an arterial blood gas test is something that measures the amount of arterial gases, such as oxygen and carbon dioxide. So, essentially, we do this test for patients who are critically, usually they're having some type of respiratory problem, and we're trying to get an accurate representation of their blood gases. So, we're trying to identify how well their lungs are perfusing, how well oxygen is getting through their system. That's why we do this exam. So the first step when it comes to learning ABGs is that you need to first memorize this table. Okay, you need to first memorize the normal range elements first. So in the middle I have for you, well, first I have the ABG elements. All of them, and then an example of a normal value, and then the ranges. So the pH, the normal pH, we have 7.35 to 7.45, and then we have the PaO2 80 to 100 millimeters of mercury. Your O2 sat is going to be 92 or to 93%, 100% oxygen, and carbon dioxide is 35 to 45 millimeters of mercury. And then the bicarb is usually about 22 to 26 milliequivalent. So one of the reasons why people struggle with ABGs is that you may not have a clear foundation on what you need to know. So you need to first, at minimum, memorize the normal ranges for pH, CO2, and bicarb. Okay, so that's the first step. Just memorize those normal ranges first. Before you do anything, before you try to interpret anything. Then, now you can move into the three steps that I break down for ABG interpretation. So, the step number one is that you have to first identify if the pH is acidosis or alkalosis. So, is it acidosis or alkalosis? Step two, identify if it's respiratory or metabolic. And then step three, identify the compensation level. So is it partially compensated, compensated, or uncompensated? So if you break down ABG interpretation into these new steps, you're more likely to understand how to interpret it. So let's start off with the first step, step number one. All right, so you have to first, before we talk about metabolic, respiratory, anything, we have to first identify, okay, is it acidosis or alkalosis? All right, that's the first thing. Is this an acidotic problem or alkalotic problem? So when we look at, for example, acidosis, acidemia, what that means is that your pH, so just the pH only, is less than 7.35, or if it's alkalotic, then it's greater than 7.45. So you use the pH balance or pH range in order to help judge if it's acidotic or alkalotic. All right. So if it's less than 7.35, it's acidotic problem. If it's greater than 7.45, it's an alkalotic problem. Now let's evaluate if it's respiratory or metabolic. So here's how you determine if it's respiratory or metabolic. So we start off, if it's a respiratory problem, this is determined if the carbon dioxide is less than 35. All right. So this is the part that confuses some people sometimes. But if the CO2 is less than 35, it's alkalosis. But if the CO2 is greater than 45, it's acidosis for CO2. Okay? And think of it in this way. If you have a patient who, let's say they're in a lot of pain, and think about how we normally function. We normally function by breathing in oxygen and breathing out CO2. right? So if somebody is in a lot of pain, what are they doing? They're not taking that many deep breaths, so they're retaining more CO2. So because they're retaining more of this carbon dioxide, that is considered respiratory acidosis. That's the acidotic problem with CO2. And then if it's too low, then that's alkaline problem. Metabolic now. If it's a metabolic problem, then that means the bicarb levels are going to be if it's going to be less than 22. If the bicarb is less than 22, that's an acidotic that's a metabolic acidotic problem. If the bicarb is greater than 26, that's a metabolic alkalotic problem. Okay, so that's essentially how you determine if it's respiratory or metabolic is by does now at this point, which of these lab values is the same state as the pH? So essentially, okay, first figure out is the pH acidotic or alkalotic for pH. Then look at the CO2 and the bicarb. Between the CO2 and the bicarb, which is the same as the pH? All right, so if the pH is acidotic, between the CO2 and the bicarb, which of those is also acidotic? That's how you determine which problem it is. Then from there, now you're going to look at compensation levels. So when it's compensated, we have the pH level is normalized. So that means that the pH will actually be in the normal range. So it's compensated. Uncompensated means that all of the values, the pH, the CO2, and the bicarb are not within the normal range, period. Whether it's low or high, that doesn't matter. It's pretty much the same if it's abnormal, right? If it's abnormal. Partially compensated is where the pH is abnormal and then the CO2 or the bicarb is abnormal, right? It's abnormal for its normal range. Once again, that's why I said it's so important for you to memorize the normal ranges so that way you don't get confused really quickly. So let's do an example of this. Look at this question. Your pH here is 7.32, right? And the carbon dioxide is 52 and the bicarb is 22. What's the interpretation? So if you would need to stop the video, if you want to take your time. So first, step one, what's the pH? The pH, we look at the pH to determine if this is going to be acidotic or alkalotic problem. The normal pH is 7.35 to 7.45, right? So because it's less than 7.35, it's an acidotic problem, period. Now I'm going to look at the CO2 and the bicarb and look to see which of these values is also acidotic. So CO2 is 52. Well, we just remember that if CO2 is greater than 45, that's an acidotic for CO2. And the bicarb is 22, which is normal. So that means that because the CO2 is acidotic, also like the pH, it's a respiratory acidosis problem. And then finally, if it's uncompensated partially or compensated, well, because two out of three lab values are abnormal, right? The pH and then either the CO2 or the bicarb, it's an uncompensated issue. So the answer for here is going to be uncompensated respiratory acidosis. All right, you see that? So if you begin to break it down like this and you follow these steps, you're going to find it a lot easier to really begin to answer and interpret ABGs. If you want more help, you can go below the video. We have free guides to help you to better understand information like this. And then if you find this really helpful and you would like for myself and my team to work with you to help you to pass your NCLEX exam, then what you can do, you can click below this video and you can schedule a free NCLEX strategy session where we can identify, what you need essentially to be successful and pass your exam, regardless of how long ago it's been since you finished nursing school. And then last but not least, you can also check out our physical books and ebooks, which is all available as well below this video. Thank you so much for watching. Share this, follow, like, and subscribe, and we'll see you the next time.